Students, let us come on the next lines of the poem Bind, composed by Subramania Bharati. Already I have told you about the poetess Subramania Bharati. Let us come on the lines of the poem Bind. As you know, there is no rhyme scheme in the poem, so it is written in blank verse. It is also known as free verse because there is no rhyme scheme in this poem. So, frail crumbling houses, crumbling doors, crumbling rafters. Here the poet has used the word crumbling many times in the same line. Crumbling, crumbling, crumbling. So, here is the use of repetition. Same word is repeated in the same line. In the next line also there is crumbling. So, when the same word is when same word comes in the consecutive lines, then here is anaphora. So there are two figure of speech, repetition and anaphora, because the same word comes in the consecutive line. So let us see the lines. Frail crumbling houses. The houses are easily broken. If they are easily broken, they can be, the wind can be forced them to fall. Frail crumbling houses, crumbling doors. Doors means weak doors and weak rafters. Rafters are the support below the ceilings. It gives the support to the ceiling, rafters. So frail crumbling houses, crumbling doors, crumbling rafters, crumbling wood, crumbling bodies, crumbling lives, crumbling heart. So it harms, the wind harms to the easily broken houses, easily broken doors, weak rafters, weak wood and weak bodies, weak lives and weak hearts. So make yourself firm and strong, otherwise wind will spoil you. The wind god winnows and crushes them all. Here the poet used the word god for wind. The wind god winnows and crushes them all. It separates them, removes, you know, winnowing. Winnowing is the word that is used, winnowing is used to separate the chaff or husk from the grain. So as husk or chaff is removed from the grain, in the same way god wind also removes, spoils, harms those things that are weak and crushes them all. And crushes them, spoils them. Crush means spoil. Spoils them all. What all? All the weak things. Weak bodies, weak houses, weak doors, weak rafters, all these weak hearts, they are separated and god wind spoil all of them. What does he spoil? The weak things, weak bodies and weak lives. Those who are weak, those whose heart are weak, those whose houses are weak, if the doors and rafters are weak, all these are spoiled by god wind. Before spoiling, he separates them. Now clear these four lines? Now let us come on the next lines. He won't do what you tell him. The god wind does not listen your plead, your request. He does his work himself. So he won't do what you tell him. Whatever you tell, he does not follow. He does not listen. He does his work himself. So come, let us build strong homes. So come, the poet is calling to all of us. Let us build strong homes. All of these things that are weak, we should make everything strong. Build strong homes. Let us join to the doors firmly. And if the doors are weak, then we should fix the door in a strong way. We should make our buildings, our houses, our doors and rafters strong. Let us joint the doors firmly, strongly. Practice to firm the body, and we should practice to make the body strong. Here the word practice, there I told you about the difference between practice and practice. Here practice is verb, and if she is used, then that is noun. So practice to firm, you have to practice yourself to make the body strong, make the heart steadfast, and make the heart also strong. So you have to make the buildings strong, doors strong, rafters strong, wood strong, body strong, life strong, and your heart strong, everything strong, so that you can survive in this world. Otherwise, wind, God bid, will separate and spoil. I think the lines of the stanza is clear. Now let us come to the questions that you will attempt yourself. So question number first, what are the two powerful and destructive activities of the wind? Next question, what preparations should be made to face the fury of the wind? Last question, what are the poetic devices used in the above lines? I think now this poem is clear. Thank you.